Tomorrow on ABC's World News Tonight with Peter Jennings. A year after the breakup of AT&T, changes in the telephone system have some consumers still confused as competing companies battle it out for your service.
Good evening. Eyewitness News at 10 is next, and tonight Chicago's heading into 1985 with a bang, a big wet one as snow and wind pummel our area this New Year's Eve. We'll have that story and the story of a stubborn fire that wipes out millions of dollars of art in an Evanston museum.
Also tonight, Chicago finally has a 1985 budget. We'll tell you who won and who lost in the budget battle. Plus, we'll look ahead as the winning Bears take their act to San Francisco. And Roger Ebert gives his list of the 10 winning movies from 1984. Those stories and more next on Eyewitness News.
Was that a movie?
At Long John Silver's, we know you have a lot of choices to make this time of year.
Ho, ho, ho.
So here's an easy choice. Shrimp, chicken, and our famous fish together.
Yeah, but should I start with the shrimp, the chicken, or the fish?
It's our season's choice platter. Shrimp, chicken, and fish. All at a special holiday price. So no matter where you start, it's a good choice. Long John Silver's season's choice platter.
Time to play the real game. Score with the pros. In this Super Bowl, you could win up to $50,000. Look for details at this display where you buy Coke. And play with the game piece in your Sunday paper January 6th.
Some 30 years ago, this Mr. and Mrs. got themselves a family cat named Dreyfus and invested $10,000 in the Dreyfus Fund. You'll be delighted to know that today, the $10,000 has grown to more than $348,000.
Sir? Madam? Dreyfus?
The Dreyfus Fund, an American success story.
It's my anniversary, Tuesday at 9!
This is Eyewitness News with Mary Ann Childers, Joel Daly for John Drury, Jerry Taft with weather, Mike Adamley on sports, and the Eyewitness News team. This is Eyewitness News.
Good evening, everyone. On this New Year's Eve, heavy snow is making Chicago streets slick and dangerous. And state police estimate one of every five drivers on the road tonight is drunk. Keith Bromery reports on the treacherous conditions of roads and drivers.
What started out this afternoon as freezing rain quickly changed over to sleet and blowing snow by the evening rush hour. That combination brought traffic to a crawl here on the Kennedy Expressway tonight. Numerous accidents were reported throughout the city as the temperatures continued to drop and the visibility worsened.
We gear up especially for tonight, seeing that it's a holiday season, especially with the weather conditions it is. We have extra enforcement troops out there to take appropriate action and help disabled motorists.
Are you expecting a lot of problems tonight because of the road conditions?
Yes, we are, especially in road conditions, especially with the holidays. Yeah, we expect a lot of problems, but we should be able to stay on top of it.
And conditions weren't a whole lot better here on Lakeshore Drive, where freezing rain and sleet played havoc with motorists. City plows and salt trucks did their best to keep up with the steadily worsening conditions. Late tonight, State Street appeared virtually deserted as the snow continued to fall. Surprisingly, the bad weather didn't seem to bother those who were out tonight for a little holiday celebration.
It's a place to be for New Year's Eve.
But isn't the weather kind of lousy?
You got to learn to live with it, and you'll enjoy it when you learn to live with it.
Yeah. I'm from Tucson, and this is the first white Christmas I've had in 10 years, and I just love it, yeah.
When the celebrating is over and partygoers hit the road, it might be good to know that free coffee is being provided for those who might want it at each tollway oasis in Illinois. But perhaps the best advice for coping with this weather was offered by this billboard. Florida looks very good from here. Keith Brummery, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
And tonight, the Streets and Sanitation Department is asking drivers to avoid parking on all major streets in Chicago until the snow removal crews have a chance to clear them. And Jerry Taft is here to tell us how much snow they'll have to clear tonight, Jerry.
Well, actually, Joel, we already have about 3 to 4 inches on the ground up to the north and about 1 to 2 inches down to the south. We could see as much as 5 to 7 inches in the north sections and about 2 to 4 inches down to the south. Let's take a look at a radar plot. This one plotted about 15 minutes ago, and on the radar plot, you can see that it's not just Chicago. The precipitation extends all the way back through Missouri down into Arkansas. And if we put the rain-snow line on there, you'll see that north of that line is where the snow is, south of that is rain, and there's also a flash flood watch out for central and southern Illinois and portions of Missouri. So a very messy New Year's Eve, so if you're going out, be careful.
Or stay in, better yet. Well, Jerry, Chicagoans can at least go to bed this New Year's Eve knowing that in 1985, the snow will be removed and the garbage will be picked up. The city of Chicago finally has a new budget. Andy Shaw reports that city council factions brought the budget battle right down to the wire.
Hello, this has been a difficult process. This has been democracy at its best.
Finance Chairman Eddie Burke ending the titanic battle of the budget tonight, calling it the best in the country. Agreed on this afternoon after Burke and opposition leader Eddie Vrdolyak meet privately with Mayor Washington. The budget does most of what Burke and Vrdolyak want. Cuts property taxes $21 million. Adds 500 police officers. Provides rebates for garbage collection to condominium owners. And eliminates 900 new unfilled jobs from the budget.
We had all those things, and we still have them in our budget, and it's the right budget for the city of Chicago.
As for Mayor Washington, he gets about 350 new jobs to fill, some in his own office, and the power over city government that his opponents wanted to take away.
It would have eroded executive power. That was all taken out, so as a result of that, he is able to continue to run the city that is in a way that I'm sure the city charter intended.
The power grab fails, that's his victory.
That's correct. That's exactly right.
So everyone wins something tonight, including the people who live in Chicago. They're spared a New Year's Eve crisis in their government, and for once, a tax is going down and not up. From City Hall, Andy Shaw, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Firefighters are still on the scene tonight of a fire at Evanston's Byer Museum. The building is gutted, its contents destroyed, and although it will be days before the damage can be completely estimated, it's likely to be in the millions.
By 8 o'clock tonight, the fire was almost under control, but it was only after a frustrating day-long battle involving nearly 50 firefighters from Skokie and Wilmette as well as Evanston. Their efforts were hampered by the bitter cold and driving sleet. Entry was impossible until a short time ago because the interior stairwells were destroyed. Firefighters believe the blaze broke out either in the basement or the first floor sometime early this morning. It apparently burned for several hours before it was discovered this afternoon. But the big problem came this evening when the flames reached the third floor.
Once the fire hit the third floor, the whole third floor had mushroom out, and then we had it come through the roof. We've had roof collapse, and the problem is until we get personnel inside to start to hit the hot spots, we won't be able to extinguish the fire.
The museum had been open to the public for 3 years. It housed more than 3,000 paintings, manuscripts, and rare artifacts collected in 20 years of world traveling by Evanston businessman Stephen Byer and his wife Barbara.
This was a wonderfully eclectic collection of pictures and gems and some beautiful old manuscripts, letters from historic people, a collection of silverware. Just a real community asset it's become in the last several years.
The cause of the blaze will be investigated. Three firefighters were slightly injured in the fire, but they were treated and released from an Evanston hospital. Joel?
Marianne, an elderly woman is dead and 12 other people are injured tonight following an explosion that ripped through an apartment building in San Antonio, Texas. The blast destroyed 8 apartments in the complex, leaving more than 40 people homeless. Authorities say the explosion was apparently caused by a natural gas leak. Rescue crews and heavy equipment were brought in to move debris in the search for more possible victims. But tonight, authorities say all of the building's residents have been accounted for. And New York subway shooter has surrendered tonight and is facing felony charges. 37-year-old Bernard Goetz gave himself up in New Hampshire. Police say he has admitted shooting for use in a subway car earlier this month. That shooting touched off a controversy in New York City, some horrified by the incident, but others say Goetz, the so-called vigilante gunman, is, in their minds, a hero.
If he was being robbed, hey, he had to do what he had to do. Self-defense, simple as that.
If it was self-defense, I feel he did the right thing. It's about time someone stood up for himself.
If that's the case, I think they should let the man try him and let him go free.
The four shooting victims are still hospitalized tonight. Eyewitnesses say the four were trying to rob Getz at the time of the shooting, but one of the victim's relatives claims the boys were merely asking Getz for money to play video games.
Joel, a convicted killer is in custody, and nearly 200 passengers and crew members are safe after a hijacking tonight to Cuba. The American Airlines flight was en route from the Virgin Islands to New York City when the convict overpowered his guards and ordered the plane to Havana. No one was injured in the hijacking. The plane was refueled and sent back to New York City. The hijacker was going to New York to stand trial for murder. Still to come on Eyewitness News, President Reagan maps out armed strategy on his New Year's vacation. We'll show you how some Chicagoans are ringing in the new year. And Roger Ebert ends 1984 with a list of his favorite movies from this year.
Your special secret recipe deserves the very best. Like something good to spice it up with just the perfect zest.
Talk about variety. At Jewel, you'll find all kinds of fresh fruit and vegetables. Everything from the sweetest bell peppers to the zippiest jalapenos.
A little extra special zing, that's important too.
Hey, Chief, where's the fire?
If it's important to you, it's important to Jewel.
Tomorrow, New Year's Day, Wix will be open from 10 to 9 for the final hours of Wix biggest sale of the year. Come in and see those amazing shrinking prices. Come face to face with unexpected quality. Behold gigantic savings 10 to 70% in every corner of the store. Your last chance to be dazzled, be startled. Be here early tomorrow for the last hours of Wix biggest money-saving sale of the year. Only at Wix. Surprisingly, Wix.
Tell me the truth, Sam. Does Reynolds plastic wrap really cling better than the leading brand?
Watch this. Reynolds plastic wrap and the leading brand.
Oh, the Reynolds holds its shape better.
That's the secret to Reynolds' super tight cling. But here's the real test. Wrap two pieces of cheese, wait 5 minutes, and see for yourself.
Seeing is believing, Sam.
Remember, for better cling, use Reynolds quality plastic wrap, the plastic wrap professionals use.
For real value, test drive an 85 station wagon at Solozzi Edelson Chevrolet.
We have a huge selection of wagons ready for immediate delivery.
Low prices like this have made Solozzi Edelson the number one Chevrolet dealer in Chicagoland.
And we guarantee you can't beat our deal on any Chevy car or truck, or we'll give you back the difference in cash.
At Solozzi Edelson Chevrolet in Elmhurst at York and Roosevelt Roads.
Where you always save more money.
President Reagan is making this a working holiday. The president and Mrs. Reagan are ringing in the new year at the lush California estate of publisher Walter Annenberg. But the president is also preparing for the upcoming arms talks with the Soviets. He met today with National Security Advisor Robert McFarlane and has scheduled meetings for tomorrow and later this week with other members of his cabinet. No word on exactly what was discussed in today's session. Artificial heart patient William Schrader will also celebrate the new year tonight, though perhaps more quietly than the president. Doctors have given Schrader permission to stay up until midnight with his family and to toast 1985. Earlier this evening, Schrader shared a special New Year's Eve dinner with his family. And Mrs. Schrader today publicly thanked all the people who've given her husband support since his operation. Schrader is steadily recovering from a stroke he suffered 2 weeks ago. Last night, he played his children in Gin Rummy, and he won.
Should old acquaintance be forgot, never brought to mind? Not a chance. Not on New Year's Eve. Whether or not, it's party time in Chicago. A number of hotels have the big bands and expect the big crowds. As many as 7,000 people are expected to crowd into the Hyatt Regency to welcome 1985, complete with party hats, noisemakers, bubbling champagne, and exploding balloons. Those who don't care to go uptown can go down home at the Bar RR Ranch. No cover, no minimum, and no reason not to dance to the good country sounds of the Sundowner. As for the rest of you who plan to enjoy the evening vicariously in front of your television set, you'll witness the end of a New Year's Eve tradition. In Manhattan's Times Square, this is the last year that big glowing globe will drop down the pole at the count of 12. That will happen in less than an hour, right here on Channel 7.
Well, hardy Chicagoans will also conduct their own New Year's countdown at midnight under the Marshall Field clock at State and Randolph. You want to get soaked again?
They better be real hardy. I don't think I'm that tough. Jerry Taft is coming up with more on the forecast for the first day of 1985. And Roger Ebert wraps up the old year with his movie picks.
Here is the time for a party!
And the best party in town is your Nissan dealer's year-end selling bash. It's time to go trucking, Featherfeet, to talk deals with Nissan dealers. The 85 standard pickup still at the 84 list price. And among leading trucks in its class, it has the most torque and no one beats its horsepower. Choice of 16 models like King Cabs, 4x, Fords, Long Beds, and they all have to go! So start the new year smart at the year-end selling bash at your all-American Metro Datsun dealers.
At Long John Silver's, we know you have a lot of choices to make this time of year.
Ho, ho, ho.
So here's an easy choice. Shrimp, chicken, and our famous fish together.
Yeah, but should I start with the shrimp, the chicken, or the fish?
It's our season's choice platter. Shrimp, chicken, and fish. All at a special holiday price. So no matter where you start, it's a good choice. Long John Silver's season's choice platter.
Memories of the smiles we left behind. Smiles we gave to one another.
Why trust moments like these to anything other than Kodak videotape? It captures the sights and sounds of every moment with color that's beautifully accurate, unmistakably Kodak.
For the way we were.
When the moment means more, trust it to Kodak videotape.
You know, you could win $100,000 instantly in Moolah Instant Lottery.
Well, Happy New Year, Jerry.
How about those bears, huh?
Listen, you said there's a chance we could get it. You should know.
Well,
you don't have to look at your computer. Look at the calendar.
Joel, if we all knew, you wouldn't need a weatherman. You could just run with the,
no,
you know, the stuff
you
off
anyway.
The wire. Anyway, it did take a slight turn. The storm is now down in Arkansas. It took a slight turn to the right, which actually is bad news for us because it puts us more in the snow and out of the rain. And for that reason, we do have a winter storm warning out for tonight and tomorrow. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. Here's a look at the satellite photo taken about a half an hour ago. You can see the swirl of the storm. The center of the storm is down to the south, and the cloud cover is over the entire area, and we do expect that to hold into tomorrow. Here's the radar plot, and earlier in the show I showed you the rain snow line just to the south of Chicago. So northern Illinois getting snow, and even though temperatures right along the lakefront are above freezing, the air at 2,000 or 3,000 feet is below freezing, so it falls down in the form of snow, although a lot of it is melting right along the lakefront. The lakefront reading now 34, rest of the readings right around freezing, and that'll be basically what it'll be all night. A strong northeast wind, 32 on the temperature at O'Hare, a wind chill of 11 above, so it's rather messy out there. Now you can see the storm, you can see the pull of moisture from the south, the center of the storm now in Arkansas, pulling in a lot of Gulf moisture. It's a very strong storm. Up to the north we have high pressure that's pulling in cold air. The two combine right across our area to give us quite a bit of snow with that moisture. The center of the track now is plotted in Arkansas, and that track is moving to the northeast and will make its way into northern Indiana by noon tomorrow, by midnight in southern Illinois, and then it'll make it into Indiana by 6 a.m. and then slow down a little bit. The heavy snow band extends from eastern Iowa across northern Illinois. Tomorrow we'll be in the clouds. We will have snowfall through the area. The storm will move off to the east, and it will be cold, temperatures only in the 20s. Let's take a look at the forecast. First of all, for tonight, a winter storm warning, 5 to 7 inches of snow to the north and to the west, 2 to 4 inches of snow to the south and to the east, with an overnight low of 28. For tomorrow, snow diminishing to flurries by afternoon, windy and colder tomorrow, with temperatures falling throughout the day. So it'll be in the 20s tomorrow also. Then Wednesday and Thursday we'll get some sunshine, but cold with highs only in the 20s. So I guess we could call it a typical New Year's Eve.
Wouldn't be Chicago if it weren't like that. Up next, Roger Ebert reveals his top 10 movie favorites for 1984. And the Sting go for a 10th straight win tonight against Cleveland.
By far the best and funniest work yet done by Dylan. Crenna is extremely funny, and Elizondo is excellent. Vincent Canby, New York Times. The Flamingo Kid is the perfect antidote to winter chill. It produces enough laughs and good sentiment to warm you from the inside out. Jack Matthews, USA Today. It's very funny. I liked Mac Dillon, and there's a terrific star performance by Richard Crenna. Two thumbs up. Siskel and Ebert at the movies. The Flamingo Kid, rated PG-13, now playing at a selected theater near you.
In the last few years, Solosi Edelson has become the largest Chevrolet dealership in Illinois.
The reason is simple. We guarantee you can't beat our deal anywhere on any new Chevrolet car or truck, or we'll give you back the difference in cash.
So, before you buy any make of car or truck, make the one stop that makes sense and saves you dollars.
At Solosi Edelson Chevrolet in Elmhurst, at York and Roosevelt Roads.
Where you always save more money.
Of the hundreds of films that were released this year, our man at the movies, Roger Ebert, says a few are worth remembering. Here are Roger's picks of the best 10, 1984.
It's a great tradition at the end of the year for a movie critic to go back over his whole year of reviews and find the 10 films that he thinks were the year's best. Here's my list for 1984. The year's best picture was Amadeus, a glorious, passionate fantasy inspired by the life of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Do you mind if I sit down?
The number two film, Paris, Texas, with Nastassja Kinski, the story of a man who tries to put his life back together again after wandering through the desert for years. Number three, Love Streams, a promiscuous failing writer played by John Cassavetes, searches for love, finds sex, discards it, and keeps on looking. Number four on my list, this is Spinal Tap, a satire on the whole genre of rock documentaries and TV shows that cover entertainment as if it were news.
Watch out! Whoa!
Number five, The Cotton Club. It's Francis Ford Coppola's high-budget saga about blacks, gangsters, and jazz in Harlem of the 1920s.
I was just an unindicted co-conspirator like everybody else.
Number six on my list, Secret Honor, a film almost no one saw, unfortunately, that betrayed Richard Nixon in the aftermath of Watergate.
They won't let me in.
Number seven, The Killing Fields. It tells the story of a friendship between a journalist and his Asian translator during the Cambodian War.
I don't need them to baby.
Number eight, Stranger Than Paradise, a Hungarian's American dream fades in and out and ends in a happy miracle.
Choose me, choose me, choose me, baby.
Number nine, Choose Me, a lurid neon-lit film about three strangers who wander into each other's lives with unpredictable results. And number 10, Purple Rain, starring the rock king Prince. If they all have one thing in common, it's that all 10 of those films were movies that somebody felt could be made, even though Hollywood thought they had no commercial potential. It's great that people continue to make the movies they believe in, and that makes those extra special as a list of the 10 best. I'm Roger Ebert, Eyewitness News.
Mike Adamley's next with a look ahead at the Bears' big day in San Francisco and a look at some of the college bowl games.
No matter what shape you're in, everybody needs exercise.
In exercise, Nautilus is the undisputed leader for a very simple reason. It works.
If you're serious about exercise, and you should be, why not the best?
For full information about the new and revolutionary Nautilus for the home, call toll-free 1-800-445-2000. That's 1-800-445-2000.
Oh, I discovered a new store. Well, not a new store, but new to me. Montgomery Ward. New because I didn't know they carried so many brand names. Sony, Maytag, Jordache, and Selection. In microwaves alone, I saw 9 different models. So I became a new Montgomery Ward customer.
Could you come? Things are changing at Montgomery Ward, and we're earning some pretty tough customers.
I'm so glad you two could come over.
Can I have another cup of cocoa?
He never asks for a second cup of my cocoa. Come here.
Don't you use new Hills Brothers cocoa?
You mean Hills Brothers makes cocoa now?
Introducing Hills Brothers old-fashioned cocoa with real Dutch cocoa that makes it rich and chocolatey. Hills Brothers cocoa, the new cocoa with the old-fashioned taste.
Where'd you get it?
My mom.
Now's the time to put you in motion.
Now's the time. And Chicagoland's Dodge dealers are out to sell every remaining 84 Dodge car and truck in inventory by New Year's Eve. The clock is ticking. So now's the time for the sensational Dodge Caravan. And buy before New Year's Eve, qualified buyers get no payments till March 1985. Now is the time. Till New Year's Eve at your nearby Dodge dealer. 40 strong across Chicagoland.
Well, looking back at 1984, Mike, been a big year for sport.
More things have happened in this last year in Chicago than have had to happen in the last 20. It's been sensational with the Cubs, and you start in 83 with the White Sox and the Sting. My goodness, it's been.
What a way to start
85.
Here,
Mike.
You know, the Bears are savoring this final day of 1984 after romping the Redskins yesterday at RFK Stadium. But tomorrow it's back to business. The Bears will fly to Santa Rosa, California tomorrow evening and prep for the San Francisco 49ers. Now, the 49ers went 15-1 during the regular season, making them the favorites in this NFC Championship game, but that's just the way the Bears like it.
All the records go out the window, and they know that, and we know. What we did in September, what they did in September, October, doesn't matter. It comes down to next Sunday for 60 minutes, and that'll determine who goes on. And we know that very well. I'm sure they're aware of it, too.
People still doubt us. I think they should turn the TVs on Sunday and see what we can do. And
to be in the locker room and see so many guys elated with what had happened, you know, it just made you almost wanted to put tears in your eyes. Things like that, you know, you treasure forever. But that Super Bowl ring, it exemplifies the mark of excellence in your field, and that's what everybody shoots for.
And as the Bears go for that Super Bowl ring and start the new year out in the West Coast practicing for the 49ers, college football's elite teams will be playing for keeps as January 1st traditionally means bowl games. But tonight down in Houston, a little something to whet your bowl appetite. West Virginia's Kevin White airs one out. A perfect strike to number one Gary Mullen, a 62-yard touchdown, and time for a little Blue Bonnet Bowl boogaloo. TCU was never in this game. Here White throws his third touchdown pass of the game to fullback Ron Wolfley as the unranked Mountaineers put a whipping on the Horned Frogs 31-14. Now, meanwhile, in Atlanta at the Peach Bowl, Purdue's Jim Everett threw three touchdowns in the first half, this one to Steve Griffin. If you like the dance in Houston, get a load of this one. I don't have any idea what you call this Indian love call. Virginia coach, however, George Welch didn't care. His Cavaliers had the last laugh as Kenny Stadlin connects in a 22-yard field goal. The Cavaliers won a 27-24 in their first bowl appearance ever. Now, this is the way the smorgasbord looks tomorrow. First two games in the Fiesta Bowl, Miami of Florida versus UCLA. Then it's Doug Flutie and Boston College versus the Houston Cougars in the Cotton Bowl. In the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl, the Big Ten champ Ohio State will take on the Pac-10 champ Southern California. And then that night, Orange Bowl, Oklahoma. This one may be for the national championship. The Sooners, number two in the country, will play Washington. And then the Sugar Bowl, it's Nebraska versus LSU. Now, in soccer at the stadium tonight, the red-hot Sting ended the year with a bang. Willie Roy will be popping the champagne cork tonight as Karl-Heinz Granitza and company won their 10th straight game. The Sting continued their amazing string tonight, trailing 4-3 in the second half. Watch Karl-Heinz from the impossible angle coming up right here, and the shot somehow found the mark. And then 11 minutes into overtime, watch this shot. Jerry Gray will feed it to Granitza, and Karl-Heinz will look over his shoulder. Here it comes. He bangs it home. 10 in a row for the Sting. Goal number 28 for Granitza. A 5-4 win over the Cleveland Force. One final note, Kentucky upset number 11 Kansas in college basketball. And we talk about all the superstars we have in Chicago. It's a shame that soccer isn't more popular because Karl-Heinz Granitza deserves to be put right alongside Michael Jordan and Walter Payton, Ryan Sandberg, and the others.
I was just thinking, Mike, you know, one reason that you came with Channel 7 from NBC was that you got a little tired of the traveling. Look at you now.
On the road.
On the road again.
If you're on the road tonight, watch out and have a great New Year's Eve. We'll see you tomorrow.
Happy New Year. See you tomorrow.
Just when you think your party has reached the end, get
Get ready for a sale that's worth celebrating. Pepper's gigantic New Year's Day sale for 6 hours only from 1 to 7 p.m. Incredible savings on Pepper's most popular waterbeds, bedroom furniture, and accessories at savings of 20, 30, up to 40%. But it's this New Year's Day for 6 hours only at Pepper's Waterbeds.
Rest assured. Rest assured. Peppers.
With assured reservations, you've got our word.
Yes, the American Express card. That's right.
When you travel, always ask for an American Express card assured reservation. Your hotel room will be there.
Am I too late?
No. I waited up.
You've got our word. Ask for an American Express card assured reservation at Sheraton Hotels.
If you're looking for the most value for your money, test drive an 85 Cavalier at Salozzi Edelson Chevrolet.
We have a huge selection of Cavaliers in stock, ready for immediate delivery.
Prices like this have made Salozzi Edelson the number one Chevrolet dealer in Chicagoland.
And we guarantee you can't beat our deal on any Chevy car or truck, or we'll give you back the difference in cash.
At Salozzi Edelson Chevrolet in Elmhurst at York and Roosevelt Roads.
Where you always save more money.
Party down with the best rock videos of 1984. Rock on, Chicago, midnight tonight.
Support Catholic Charities Foster Care Services.
Nightline will return tomorrow at its regular time. For now, though, from all of us at ABC News, our very best wishes for a happy new year.